In just 4 days, Miguel Cotto and Saul Canelo Alvarez will enter the ring. Pay-per-view fight is for the 160 world title. However, this morning, the WBC have stripped Miguel Cotto from... Miguel Cotto was stripped from his title because he didn't comply to the rules and regulations of WBC.
Which is
pay the dues. The WBC, you have to pay sanctioning fees. And also, the WBC said, I was in their convention in China. They said that the winner of this fight will face Gennady. Maybe, and I don't know this for sure, maybe Cotto said he's not going to face Gennady and he's his own boss. So whatever the case may be, they stripped him. Now, if Canelo wins, he gets the title. Cotto wins, he doesn't get the title.
Let me ask you this. Who do you think will win?
Canelo, easy.
I got Cotto.
You don't know boxing. What do you think?
I think Canelo's the younger fighter. He's getting stronger.
Like, you don't know boxing. Everything can happen. Everything is possible. You see Rousey and Holmes.
Yeah,
everything
thank
is
you, Snow Queen.
Everything is possible. It's sport.
Okay, let me tell you why.
And he knows I know it, but it's okay.
Let me tell you why Canelo will win.
You tell me, and I'm going to tell you why.
He has the bigger body build. He's the natural 160-pounder. He shouldn't be really fighting at 155. He should be fighting at 160. He's going to probably rehydrate to 170.
Well, that was Cotto's idea to 155. Because Cotto's already 140 fighter. Cotto's already old. His face swells up fast. He already lost a few times in a ring where he didn't finish the fight.
Let me tell you why. I'm going to tell you why Cotto can beat him.
Okay.
If he goes past six rounds, Canelo has terrible conditioning skills. And I guarantee you, if he gets past six rounds, it's going to be a different fight.
It won't go past six.
Okay, you want to bet on past six rounds?
I have 500 push-up bets with D'Antoni, 500 push-up bets with, what's the kid from Nebraska? Terrence Crawford?
Okay.
I'll bet you 500 push-ups.
You got it.
You're gonna you do 500 push-ups.
You're going to be in shape.
I haven't.
You're going to be in great shape.
I haven't shape.
You're going to do a 1,500 push-ups.
No,
let me say something.
Canelo would win.
I don't like, Canelo, there's a blueprint really to beat Canelo, and that is to get him in the later rounds. Trout almost had him. Mayweather got him. He had problems with the other dude.
You talking about Laura. But he did win. Laura
the only fight that he looked good in, and that was against James, what's the young boy?
Kirkland.
And Kirkland's is known to get crap. You know what I mean? Cotto's gonna box. Now he's right about the weight.
I mean, Canelo boxes too.
Listen.
But he's not as good as boxing.
If you go to New York, everybody says Cotto. You go to Puerto Rico, everybody says Cotto.
Yeah.
You go to
anything,
Mexico.
Mexico, Southern California.
I'm not Mexican.
What are you from?
My dad's from Guatemala and my mom's Salvadorian.
And so who are you going for?
I'm kind of going for. I want Canelo to fight Gennady, but I kind of want Cotto to win. And
see, even with him saying he does Canelo. Even though he said Canelo, he wants Cotto to win.
Snow Queen LA all the way from Siberia. Who wins? Cotto or Canelo?
I go for Canelo.
Why?
I believe more in mental preparation. And I think he's hungrier. That's why I think he'll win. I don't know.
What happened?
Ricky. She said Canelo wins, he said Cotto wins, he said he wants Cotto to win, but Canelo will win. What do you think?
I got Canelo.
You're betting the whole world. How much money on the line?
I got right now $2,000 right now. You want to bet? $2,000. With a Filipino, yeah, baby.
It's gonna be a good fight, a really good fight.
With the happy ending. All right, Dan and Green stuck to his phone.
I'm sorry, it was business. Let me say something. Well, not now. Now, let me say, what's your nationality?
Guatemala.
Okay, and he said he really kind of want Cotto, even though he believes Canelo can win. No, let me say this. Because of your fan base, I'm going to be called the N-word because I picked Cotto. And whenever they don't like you, they're going to call you something.
But Nelson, here in Southern California, how many times a day do people think you're Mexican?
Either Filipino or Mexican.
But every day, all day, right?
I didn't put you Filipino, but I put you Spanish. I knew Spanish. But I don't ever like to say Mexican anymore, because I remember when I first came out, I thought Ricky was a Mexican, and Ricky's not, so...
Ricky's from Guatemala, right?
No,
Ricky's from China. Ricky, aren't you Chinese, Ricky?
Honduras.
Yeah, I'm Chinese.
Yeah. He's Bruce Lee's cousin's nephew's uncle's cousin's grandfather's nephew, friend.
No, the thing about nationality is it could help a person like Canelo's career out a lot. He has a whole Mexican fan base. I used to be a Canelo fan until he fought Mayweather. I thought he could do way more with Mayweather.
But... Well, he was 21, you know.
Stop!
There's no.
Stop using age. Mike Tyson was the youngest world champ.
That don't mean anything.
Thank you.
Age don't mean nothing.
Stop, man. Thank you.
Nobody can beat Floyd.
Thank you. For 5 years.
I don't care if it's Canelo or Oscar De La Hoya.
The only person that could beat Floyd is Jesus, and Jesus would have to go at least 8 rounds to get him.
I'm going to say that, man.
I'm joking. Everybody knows I know the Lord.
Hey, he meant his.
Oh, you still sitting down?
I don't want to get close to my lightning.
Strike him down, Lord!
He meant Jesus Soto Carras.
Oh, you
meant
Jesus
right?
Soto Carras?
Jesus, Danny, Jesse, Jesus, not Jesus the Lord.
Jesus.
So since you interviewed Oscar, what was the purpose of Oscar writing that letter?
Yeah.
This is what Oscar told me. Oscar said.
Yeah.